determine our self-worth. Our self-worth is determined and based on the fact that God is our Father and that He loves us with an everlasting love. Amen? We're a royal priesthood. We're a chosen generation. We are a holy nation. We are peculiar people. People ought to say it ought to be something just kind of strange about you. You don't act like the rest of the world. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Because we're children of the Most High God. Romans 5 and 8 says, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Can you imagine somebody dying for someone else of their own free will they didn't sign up for? I can't even imagine it. That's why God's grace is so amazing. Very seldom will you hear someone dying for another, but Jesus loved us so much that while we were yet sinners, He died for us. That's God's amazing grace, amen?
Amen?
We're not only saved by grace, but we maintain our relationship with Father God by grace. We are healed by grace. We are delivered from our past sins by grace. We prosper by grace, amen?
Amen.
Our relationship with God is all by the grace of God. None of the benefits of salvation come to us based on our own works. It's a free gift from God. Our faith accesses this amazing grace of God. We sing that song, Amazing Grace, but we need to get that on the inside of us and really just recognize how amazing God's grace really is. Amen?
Amen.
Let's look at Colossians 2, 6 and 7. Colossians 2, 6 and 7. When James and I go to the nursing home, a lot of the songs we sing sometimes, the seniors might not know the song, but they all seem to know Amazing Grace.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Colossians, the second chapter, verses 6 and 7. And it says, as you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him, rooted and built up in Him, established in the faith as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. These scriptures are saying the same way we were born again is the same way we are to continue walking with Jesus. And that's by faith. Faith in God's grace. Salvation is by God's grace, and we maintain our daily relationship with Him by grace. Everything we do is by the grace of God. I can only stand here and teach you guys because of the grace of God. Amen. He gives me the grace to study. He gives me the grace to spend hours in the Word. And it's not a burden. It's by His grace. You have the grace to play music. I'm not so graceful, but I have the grace. But I have the grace of God.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. I'll try to be more graceful. But I do have the grace of God. Amen. Praise God. Salvation is by God's grace, and we maintain that relationship with Him by grace. Not by our performance, not by our work, but by our faith in what Jesus Christ provided. Amen. Our faith accesses the grace of God. This is why I wanted to teach on grace. I see so many believers today with a works mentality, trying to win brownie points with God through their work. We don't have to do that, amen? God's love for us is complete. No matter what you do or don't do, He's not going to love you any more or less. His love is complete right now, amen?
Amen.
Let's look at Ephesians, the second chapter. Ephesians, the second chapter. Praise the Lord. Praise God. And I know you know this one by heart, but we're going to get it before our eyes. Ephesians, the second chapter, we're going to look at verses 8 and 9. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. See, the good news is when we were born again, our spirit man instantly became righteous. And it's a part of us that's instantly righteous the minute we receive Jesus Christ as Lord. We didn't work at it. It wasn't given to us because of our performance. It was given to us by the grace of God. a free gift. And then out of gratitude for this free gift, you know what we ought to do? We ought to praise God. We ought to thank Him every morning. We ought to wake up with thanksgiving in our mouth in the morning, that we are awake, that we are alive, that we're able to go out and share the gospel with somebody. Amen? Amen. We were saved to do that, to praise Father God. We were made to praise the Lord. Amen? Amen. And to love others, and to serve other people.
Yes.
We're not just saved for our own benefit, but to serve Christ and to help build up the church. You know, the things that we do for God shouldn't be a burden. It shouldn't be a burden to come to church on Sunday. It shouldn't be a burden to practice your praise and worship. It shouldn't be a burden. Amen. I've heard people say, I got a burden for the lost. Well, it shouldn't be a burden. You ought to be excited about sharing the gospel. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Let's look at Romans the 5th chapter, and we're going to look at Romans 5:15. And I used to say that. I have a burden for this and a burden. No, I don't. I'm excited about the things of God. It's not a burden. I'm excited that God chose to use me. Amen. We ought to be excited that you're in the choir and on the praise and worship team, that you run the computers and the cameras. Be excited. Amen.
Amen.
Romans the 5th chapter, verse 15, I'll be reading from the New King James. It says, but the free gift is not like the offense. For if by one man's offense many died, much more the grace of God and that gift by grace of the one man, Jesus Christ, abounded to many. The Living Translation says, but there is a great difference between Adam's sin and God's gracious gift. A big difference, amen?
Yes.
For the sin of this one man, Adam, brought death to many. But even greater is God's wonderful grace and His gift of forgiveness to many through this other man, Jesus Christ. Through Adam's fall, sin was passed on to everybody. We had nothing to do with becoming sinners. We were born with that sin nature, amen?
Amen.
But the good news is, there's always some good news in the Bible. The good news is when we got born again, we were made righteous. 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, for He made Him to be sin who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Amen?
Amen?
We had nothing to do with being born sinners, and we had nothing to do with being made righteous. Jesus did it all. Amen?
Amen.
We didn't do anything to earn it. We couldn't earn it. We're not saved because we're good. We're saved because God is so good.
Amen.
Look at verse 16, Romans 5:16. And the gift is not like that which came through the one who sinned. For the judgment which came from one offense resulted in condemnation. But the free gift which came from many offenses resulted in justification. Adam's sin led to condemnation and produced a whole lot of offenses. All of our actions of sin were because we were by nature sinners. Amen?
Amen?
But when we received the free gift of salvation, we were justified.
Amen.
Just as if we'd never sinned.
That's right.
Isn't that good?
That's right.
The whole slate was just wiped clean, done away with. We are now in right standing with God. And that's what God's amazing grace is all about. Amen?
Amen?
We accept His grace through our faith in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's a gift of righteousness that came through one man, but it's free to anybody. Whosoever will can be saved. If your sins have already been paid for. And sad to say, people are going to go to hell with their sins paid for. All they have to do is receive forgiveness from Jesus Christ. Amen?